If you're new to Blackboard Data, this short video will help you get started. The homepage provides an introductory video which explains what Blackboard Data is and how it can benefit your institution, so you may want to take a couple of minutes to watch this. The homepage also has quick links to the main content areas of reporting and developer, which I'll explain shortly, as well as useful external links such as case studies and community groups. In the top left corner, you'll find the menu link, and this expands to show the available content. Note that you may not see all of the links shown here depending on the roles and permissions chosen for you by your institution. You can close the menu by selecting the back arrow at the top right corner of the menu. The content in Blackboard Data is split into two main areas: reporting, which contains pre-built reports focusing on learning, teaching, and leading, and developer, which provides direct access to the data model, queried using SQL, as well as documentation on the structure and content of the data model in the data dictionary. At the top of the page, you'll find a language picker to choose from multiple non-English languages and English variations. You'll also find a What's New link, which pops out a sidebar on the right to show recent changes, helpful videos like this one, and prompts for feedback. Regarding feedback, every now and again you may see a prompt at the bottom of the page, asking you to rate your experience out of 10. We value your feedback and it helps us to improve. In the bottom right corner of every page, you'll see a question mark icon which opens the relevant help page in a new window. Finally, as Blackboard Data contains sensitive information, it's important to sign out when you are finished working with the application. You'll find a sign out button in the top right corner of every page, as well as at the bottom of the main menu. You will also be signed out automatically after a period of inactivity and prompted to sign in again.